Hello everyone. In the last video, we have seen nucleophilic substitution reactions of alkyl halides. In that, we have seen the substitution of halogen by nitro group, nitrito group, nitrile group, cyano group, hydroxyl group, etc., etc. So six substitutions that we have seen. So we are continuing substitution reactions. So here the seventh application is substitution of halogen by carboxylate group. So if you are substituting halogen by carboxylate group, you will be getting esters. Okay, RCOO R dash in that manner. Okay, for that I have taken the alkyl halide over here. Okay, in order to have substitution of that, here we are taking silver salt of carboxylic acid. If this is RC double bond OOH, this is carboxylic acid. And here I will be taking silver salt of carboxylic. Okay. So what will happen? This AgX will be going and you will be getting R dash C double bond OR. So this functional group is known as ester. Okay, this is done. How this is done? Then alkyl halides are heated with alcoholic solutions of silver salts of fatty acids or esters are obtained. For example, I am taking an example of silver acetate. So this is silver acetate, and if you are treating with suppose ethyl bromide is nothing but this one, and you have to heat this in presence of alcohol. Okay, heat, then what will happen? Silver bromide will be eliminated and you will be getting ethyl acetate. This ethyl group will be this is like acetate group, right? CH3 C double bond O. This is acetate group and the ethyl group is attached over here. So this is called ethyl acetate. Okay, so we are preparing ethyl acetate by treatment of alkyl halide with silver acetate. So the eighth reaction is substitution of halogen by alkynyl group, the group which is having CC triple bond. So in that case you will be getting higher alkynes, okay, higher analogues of alkynes. Okay, so for that I have taken alkyl halide and sodium acetylnide, means sodium salt of an alkynide. Okay, so here hydrogen was there previously. How this is formed means this is a terminal alkyne, and if you are treating with sodium hydride, you will be getting this product. Okay, sodium alkynide. Okay, now what will happen? This NaX will be removed and you will be getting R C triple bond C R dash. So what will happen? Here 1, 2, 3 carbon were there initially alkyne. Now one more carbon, means one more alkyl group will be attached to you. So whatever the parent carbon, you will be getting the ring, means carbon number increased one. So that's how you are preparing higher alkynes. For example, let me write methyl iodide. If I want to increase one carbon, I am taking an carbon with one alkyl halide with one carbon, and I am taking here sodium acetylnide. Sodium, this is acetylene. If it is hydrogen, then this is sodium salt of acetylnide. And if you are treating this one, sodium iodide will be removed and you will be getting CH3 C triple bond CH. Now carbon number increased to 3. This is propyne, right? Acetylene is converted into propyne. So carbon number got increased. So this is a substitution by alkynyl group. The next reaction, that is ninth substitution reaction, is substitution of halogen by amino group. So you will be getting this will be substituted by amino group. So you will be getting RX will be converted into RNH2, like amines you are getting. Okay, the product will be alkyl halide will be converted into amines. So when heated with excess of alcoholic ammonia under pressure, alcoholic ammonia, this is NH3, right? Alcoholic ammonia with pressure, alkyl halides yield primary amines. So how this is done? So this is alkyl halide and ammonia, you will be eliminating HX. Okay, so minus HX will be happening. So this is done under high temperature and pressure,
alcohol is there, so the product will be RnH2.
RnH2. So this is the, if nitrogen is attached to only one carbon, this is called primary amine. Primary amine. However, further alkylation of amine formed, this amine formed will be further alkylated. You will be getting a mixture of primary, secondary and tertiary amines, and the quaternary ammonium salt also will be formed. How this is happening? This you might have seen in plus 2 classes. So if it is again treated with alkyl halide, like this is alkyl halide. Okay, here you can write this as one hydrogen like this. So what will happen? This primary amine, again HX elimination, minus HX. And what you will be getting? R2NH, right? See, this will be RNHR. This could be written as R2NH. Now nitrogen is attached to two alkyl groups. So in that case, it is called secondary amine. Right, now this can again can substitute another alkyl halide. Okay, so here also minus HX. Okay, so in that case you will be getting R3N like this. Okay, so this is called, nitrogen is attached to three alkyl groups. This is called tertiary amine. Now again it can add to substitute the alkyl halide, or it will be an addition product basically. Okay, how this will be happening? Here there is no HX to eliminate. Okay, so what will happen? This lone pair also will be involved in that reaction. So this lone pair will be attacking this carbon, and X minus will be going, but it will not go as such, because this will be like R4 nitrogen. Nitrogen with lone pair it attacks, so nitrogen gets a positive charge over here. So X minus will be remaining as a counter anion. So in that case, you will be getting a quaternary salt, quaternary ammonium salt. So this is that you are getting when you are treating alkyl halide with ammonia. So I have taken an example of treatment of methyl bromide with ammonia. So what will happen here? HBr elimination will be happening, minus HBr, and CH3NH2 will be forming. This is called primary amine, methyl amine. So methyl amine, what it will do? It will react with another molecule of alkyl halide. This is the second molecule of alkyl halide. This could be written as like this. Then what will happen? This HX will be eliminated, minus HX, and you would be getting, okay, again you will be treating with CH3X. Okay, CH3Br I have to write, right? So minus HBr, sorry. So what will happen? You will be getting CH3 twice NH. So this nitrogen is attached to two alkyl groups. Now this is called a secondary amine, dimethyl amine. Okay, now this dimethyl amine again with reacts with third molecule of methyl bromide, third molecule of methyl bromide, and again minus HBr will be happening. So you would be getting CH3 thrice nitrogen. There are no more hydrogens to replace. So this is tertiary amine, trimethyl amine. Okay, now this trimethyl amine again reacts with another molecule of methyl bromide. Now this will be attacking this one, bromide will be leaving, and you will be getting CH3 four times. Nitrogen loses its lone pair, and Br minus will be as a counter anion. So this is a tetramethyl ammonium bromide. This is tetramethyl ammonium bromide, which is a quaternary ammonium salt. So this is the reaction with ammonia. The 10th reaction that I am going to explain is that substitution of chlorine and bromine by iodine. Okay, so halogens like chlorine or bromine are substituted by iodine loop. So you will be getting corresponding alkyl iodides. So formation of alkyl iodides. So here I have taken alkyl halide plus potassium iodide under Bethanolic condition. This is very particular. So when alkyl chlorides or bromides are treated with or heated with, it is under heat condition. Okay, when they are heated with alkyl potassium iodides, you will be getting corresponding alkyl iodide plus KCl. Similarly, RBr plus methanolic potassium iodide under heat condition, you will be getting alkyl iodide plus KBr. For example, I have taken ethyl chloride plus potassium iodide, you will be getting ethyl iodide. Similarly, methyl bromide plus potassium iodide, you will be getting methyl iodide plus KBr. So these are the 10 substitution reaction of alkyl halides that I have discussed.